I apologize for the blunt declaration. Perhaps we should start again. I'm Theo Hoffman, attorney at law. It's a pleasure to meet you, Miss Barrett.
Oh, I think, did I just see you on Baker Street? You picked up my glove that I had dropped.
So I did.
Wow, and you work with Diane.
Correct. In fact, I will be defending you and Detective Falconeri against the wrongful death suit.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry, it's a little late, so.
Oh, I am sorry, but I fear, Ms. Barrett, that you have not been given the truth by some very well-meaning people. Frankly, and sadly, your prospects look rather bleak. I have a policy of telling my clients the unvarnished truth. It prepares them for things to come.
Hmm. Well, that's actually very refreshing. Maybe we should
Thank you. Rest assured that I've handled many high-profile cases. I am very well versed in the vagaries of celebrity.
Yes, well, so I'm assuming that you mean it's going to complicate my case.
Well, no one doubts the dead man was after you with serious intent. Unfortunately, it may be assumed that you've been given preferential treatment precisely because you are famous.
Mm, well, trust me, I have not.
Be that as it may, the plaintiff's attorneys may invoke a number of female celebrities who have been treated leniently despite their obvious guilt.
Okay, so what do we do about that?
Well, I will in fact argue the opposite of leniency in this case. Because if you were not in the public eye, this lawsuit would never have been filed. The benefit family is after media attention and deep pockets. They are, in effect, blackmailing you, despite the fact that you were in danger and you acted to protect yourself and Dante Falconeri.
Well, actually, what I did was I was trying to save a cop, which, I don't know, I feel like anyone in my position would have probably done the same thing.
Well, the problem is you are not just anyone, and we have to deal with that.
Okay, so how can I help you?
Well, why don't we begin by you telling me the unvarnished truth of exactly what happened in the alley that night.
Hey, it's Mr. Hoffman.
Yes. Yes, that's correct. Jason Morgan, I presume.
Yeah, Diane said you were going to take over Brenda's case and Dante's. Are you okay?
Yeah, I was just thinking maybe I'd go out and have like a walk and get some fresh air for a second.
I'm sorry if my questions disturbed you.
Oh.
Max is outside. He'll take you for a walk.
Oh, great. We could just finish later.
Of course.
We need to clear up a few things. I trust Diane, but I want to hear your take on the lawsuit.
Well, as I told Miss Barrett, the biggest obstacle is her celebrity.
The guy was killing Dante. Brenda shot him in self-defense.
The circumstances are open to interpretation. Miss Barrett and Detective Falconeri are closely connected to a third party, Sonny Corinthos. There was no objective witness to the shooting. The jury will be asked to believe Detective Falconeri's and Ms. Barrett's version of events.
That's good, because they're telling the truth.
Well, the jury's opinion will rest on Ms. Barrett herself. They will be keeping a close eye on how she presents herself on the stand.
The problem with that is if someone asks Brenda the wrong question, she could fall apart. That's why you need to settle this before it goes to trial.
I will certainly do my best. But in my estimation, the plaintiffs would like to cause maximum suffering for Ms. Barrett, which precludes a settlement. This will go to trial.
You need to be careful with Brenda. Because killing a man, even in self-defense, almost destroyed her.
I want round-the-clock surveillance of Brenda Barrett. Full reports on every move she makes.
Now that you have access, why not just kill her and be done with it?
Miss Barrett has information I need. I've worked hard to put myself in a position of trust. Now that she's beginning to confide in me, I'll break her down systematically until she tells me everything she knows. Only then will I take my full revenge.